Hey, yo! Happy summer solstice, baby. Oh, Paul, y'all having a good day. They want you to soak up this summer solstice, this vibration that a change is coming. You will hear this song on repeat. It's because I need y'all to suck in that summertime, summer solstice vibration. I had to get up and I ran today and I feel good. I didn't want to, my ass was lazy, but I asked my ancestors to help me get motivated. And my spirit guide, so when they told me to run, I didn't run. So they had like two blackjacks chasing my ass. And I started running. And I said, dang, y'all cruel. They said, well, I told you to run, run. So we had to put something after y'all. So make a long story short, when y'all asking y'all ancestors and y'all spirit guides to help you, by any means necessary, they're going to do it. They will light that fire out of your ass. They will end relationships. They will get you fired because they see something better for you. Let's see, they want me to do the surrender cards for y'all because a lot of y'all need to continue to surrender stuff. If you're curious about what I'm drinking, it's to help lower your cholesterol, to help lower your blood pressure. It's two cucumbers with the skin on it, so y'all got to clean the skin, a whole pineapple, and mint, and some ginger. And that's going to help if you got to poop, you got trouble pooping, that will make you poop. That will also release excess water towards you. The first one is surrender your belief in different things. This religion belief need to be open to spirituality. Just understand you have this. Well, some of y'all have the spirit of discernment. Y'all need to ask what's for me, what's not. The universe is asking you to open to the infinite nature of abundance. In this way, you can remove blocks in your life and succeed beyond your wildest dream. So stop saying you broke. Stop saying you broke. When you keep saying I ain't broke or I'm not ever going to have nothing, love is never going to find me, they're listening. So if that's it, if you keep saying that's what you want, that's what they're going to send you. Surrender your need to always be right. I'm learning that now. That is okay to say no. But I also, when people come to me, I'm quick to say, I don't know nothing about that. Let me meditate. You know, I don't know everything. So I don't act like I know everything. So if people that can vouch for me know, if I don't know something, I don't know. Or if I say I'm not getting an answer, so that means it's none of my fucking business. Sometimes it's not meant for everybody to know. Okay? Surrender your need to always be right. Give others a gift of letting them be right. Be yielding and not rigid. This will help resolve conflicts, improve your relationship. So I'm picking up my married people, my common law people. Sometimes you're wrong because you have a lot of pride and ego. You let this person always saying, I'm sorry. Well, they need to stop saying sorry. But in this scenario, y'all always saying, I'm sorry, I did wrong. Please forgive me. What can I do to make it better? And this person is laughing because they have so much pride and ego. No, motherfucker, both of y'all wrong. So you need to admit your faults and he needs to admit his faults. Y'all both have to admit it. That's how you growing and learning. Surrender to stress. I just met another spirit guide of mine. I can't pronounce his name, But he's Indian. I'm talking about the Durka Durka, the one with the red dot. His name was Lama Lama. He told me to call him Lama Lama. Mr. Lama Lama. Hey, so when I go in meditation, I say, hey, Mr. Lama Lama. And he comes. He always reminded me, he who angers you, control you. He who angers you, control you. So if you don't let anger control you, you can't be controlled. So some of y'all need to surrender to stress. You need to take a few deep breaths and exhale the tension you build up in your body. Let the stress go as you come back to enter your center. Release things that does not resonate with your higher good. Remember, he who angers you control you. Surrender to complete healing. When you feel yourself getting under the weather, or you're not feeling yourself, you have to say, I am releasing healing in my body. My body is healing. I'm letting go all this inflammation. I'm letting go this blood pressure, this heart problem, this high cholesterol, this stress. You gotta let it go. Stop asking God for healing. I mean, let me put it this way. God can heal you in two ways. He can heal you by taking you from the diseased body, or he can heal your body. So when you ask for things, ask for healing of your body. When you ask for protection of your children, ask them to bring your children safely alive home. Protection, heal them always. Don't say bring them safe, because they can bring them to you deceased. So you always need to change your words. Open fully to the loving, compassionate forces of the universe that support your physical, emotional, and spiritual healing. So you need to surrender to complete healing. You have the woman holding the heart, and then you have the man holding the heart. Your soulmate is coming in. So they want you to surrender to releasing your exes, releasing those things that you think is your attachment. A lot of y'all are getting in relationships looking for your woulda, shoulda, coulda. And it's fucking you up. Because what he or she did to you, you can't expect to find he or she in that individual. So spirit is saying your love is coming. Some of y'all about to meet your twin flame. And this is to get you out of that woulda, shoulda, coulda shit. Every time a twin flame, he's a runner, he's a track star. Every time the twin flame come into your life, it's a lesson in it. Sometimes it's a good lesson, sometimes it's a bad lesson. Some of y'all saying, well, I'm married to my twin flame. No, you're married to your soulmate twin flame. There's a difference. A twin flame cannot be controlled. That's why I said he's a runner, he's a track star. He's in there to bring you lessons and blessings. Some of y'all are getting ready to get the love that you deserve. A lot of y'all are going through an anxiety. It's because you need to release the things that does not resonate to your higher good. Also, I'm picking up my spiritual people, especially Pisces, Cancers, Aries, Sagittarius, off and on my Leos. Some of y'all going through psychic attacks because y'all very psychic. Spirit is saying you need to stay under a spiritual bath and a spiritual shower. Also, the meaning of a spiritual bath and spiritual shower is because you add in the elements and you say in prayers. You're connecting to all four elements: earth, water, fire, air. Earth, water, fire, air. Yeah, I said it right. Sometimes I forget. First off, you have to fucking clean your body. Some of y'all are taking spiritual baths and spiritual showers and y'all not cleaning yourself. You probably want to take a shower first and release everything. See the dirt coming off of you. Then you want to take your spiritual bath or spiritual shower. This is a little coconut because I like coconut. So this is dried up coconut shell. So when I do it, I always do my crown. I always do the back of my neck. When I take a bath, after I take my shower, I sit in there for 15 minutes. I read Psalms 91 or whatever Psalms you're dedicated to, and then I put it all over me. I make sure I put my face in the water. I hold it for 13 seconds so it can clear me. I get the back of my neck. Some of y'all need to take that, and it's going to relieve your anxiety. And also, you being under psychic attack, these low vibrational entities are trying to attach onto you because your light is shining. A lot of y'all have the second chakra archangel Ariel. This is your solar, which is your intuition, which is your creativity, which is your fire. Some of y'all need to start doing that, wearing orange, listening to music, eating orange fruits and vegetables. I'm hearing bell peppers. I'm hearing bell peppers. Y'all need to incorporate sweet bell peppers. Some of y'all call them sweet peppers. Some of y'all call them bell peppers. Whatever, it's a fucking pepper, okay? It's not the hot, spicy one. It's just a regular pepper. Y'all need to add to y'all food. Another one is Archangel, the seventh chakra, Archangel Uriel, which is your crown chakra. This is what I'm talking about. Some of y'all need to do a coconut head wash because your crown chakra is blocked. Some of y'all going through anxiety because a storm is coming. You got to understand, this too shall pass. Every storm is not going to last forever. It's purifying you. You're being planted. Some of y'all are being planted because y'all about to go into some money. Y'all got money coming around you. Y'all open for abundance. But y'all need to start learning appreciation. And this is going to so happen so quickly because you're taking your mind off of it. When you do any type of ritual manifestation, you have to take your mind off of it. You got to turn up. You got to let them do what they do. You got to let them do their job. What messages do you have for them? Also, thank you for watching me. Please like, subscribe, share. If you want to be in a pick a card, spirit-led reading, comment your name and stuff like that, and I will pick you. Also, I pick up the present, I pick up the past, I pick up the future. Time is fluid. This might not resonate with you, so please stop trying to make it fix. You know, try make it fit. I'm sorry, not fix. Fix too. Sometimes y'all trying to fix something that can't be fixed. So if this is not you, it's not going to resonate with all of y'all, okay? What other messages? Do love me, do love me, do. I love you. No one else but you. Spirit says some of y'all need to play this song and look at yourself in the mirror. So you need to say that you need you, you love me, and there's no one else but you. There's no one else but you. I need you. Also, you have the four aunts. Some of y'all are asking for stuff. Some of y'all are asking for stuff, but y'all not going fully detailed on your vision board, on y'all petition that y'all burning and burying and flushing down the toilet. Also, Spirit has said, if anybody know anybody that owe them motherfucking money, you need to get a brown piece of paper. Brown parchment paper is good. Brown paper sack. Reason why brown, because natural paper is brown, not white. Okay? So if you know somebody that owe you money, you need to write their name down, write the amount on it, and stick it behind the toilet. Stick it behind the toilet, and then when you start getting your money, then you flush that bitch down the toilet. That's what I'm hearing from my spirit guide, the Lama Lama. That's what he's saying. But back to this. Y'all have the four aunts. Aunts. The four aunts. So y'all asking for an individual. Y'all asking for a house. Y'all asking for a job. Y'all not going in full detail. So you asking for an office job because you're tired working in a warehouse. All right. So you get a job. They call you and say you hired. They describe this job somewhere and you thought you was qualifying. There you are doing books, just sitting there bored as fuck. You like, this is not what I was talking about. Y'all asking for a male or female to come in your life, fine, healthy, wealthy. But once again, y'all not healthy, y'all not wealthy, y'all not spiritual. Y'all asking for stuff, and then y'all might say to have good sex that can cook, or a long ding-a-ling, or whatever you want to say, however you want to say it. And then when y'all get it, the person's fucked up on the inside. Batshit crazy motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? A narcissist motherfucker. So a lot of y'all are asking spirit, God, your ancestors for Mickey Mouse. And they said, nah, Donald Duck is for you. I don't want Donald Duck. Donald Duck is yada, 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 ray, ray, ray. Mickey Mouse is this. He has everything. Once again, y'all looking at the outer appearance. And y'all not understand the mentally, the inside. Okay, looks can fade. We getting older. You die every day. You're not going to be 21 all the time. You're not going to be 25 all the time. When you look up, if God let you live, you're going to be 70. Because God only promised you 70 years. If you go above 70 years, that's a blessing. That's a denied to many. There's a lot of people getting that privilege denied to them. So when you asking for this job, this core, you have to describe it. Spirit says some of y'all need to change y'all vision board. Some of them, someone is crying out for help. and you got the four unks and they sending you help. This might be a mentor. This might be someone that's spiritual. They in your life temporarily get you up. To help lift you where you need to be lifted. Help activate you where you need to be activated. You asking for guidance. They about to send you someone. But be careful, spirit is saying. Wolves are in sheep clothing. So you need to ask your ancestors to give you signs. God will give you signs in three forms. Confirmation. Always remember three. It will resonate with you, okay? You got to be aware of the false prophets. Those are wolves and sheep coming. They'll tell you something and it never happens. It's false truth. Also, excuse me, be careful what you manifest. This is what I'm saying, manifesting. What the words is coming out of your mouth, because sometimes you asking for stuff and it's not what you really want because you didn't fully tell them exactly what you want. Some of y'all are asking for love. And this person is not for you. Yeah, he's going to teach you love, all right? And then you're going to wind up because you're not healing. So you're asking for somebody and you're ignoring them. And this person's coming in your life. It's going to teach you babies, beloveds. Love don't hurt. It's the person behind the love. You can't expect someone to properly love you when they don't properly love yourself. Just like money. People want to say money is the root of all evil. It's the person behind the money. Because money can change you for the good and money can change you for a bad. A lot of y'all are asking for a spiritual mentor. And some of y'all are going into these groups and all they want to do is hurt people. And that's not your calling. You have to know you got to walk with the light in the dark. Sometimes these fights that's happening is not your fights, they're your ancestors' fights. Help is coming to y'all. Help is coming to your ancestors, your spirit guides. They coming to help y'all and they're going to fight you. So you need to get out of your head and understand that you're going to have anything that you ever desire that you want, but you have to go fully into it. You have to describe it. So if you want this blue house with a red door, everybody's like, what does the red door mean? Red door means back in the day when pilgrimage and people walk, and they seen a red door. That's an invitation. It's like, you can live here. This is a house where you can sleep. Whatever you call those places where you can eat and sleep and whatever that they cater to you. And you, I can't think of the name of it, but that's what a red door means. So when you see that, I don't know if a lot of people know what that means, but that also means bed and breakfast. Thank you, Llama Llama. The Llama Llama. Bed and breakfast. Back in the day, a red door means bed and breakfast. A purple door means witch. It means royalty, spiritual. So you see people with a house with a red, purple door, that means spirituality, witch. I don't know if it's a bad witch or a white witch. I don't know. And I don't know why people want to put color on it, but the Llama Llama told me to specify that. Continue to walk away from the things that does not resonate with your higher good. Let's get an inspiration of the day. You are the greatest of all time. You are the GOAT. So you need to get up and say your affirmations like, I am powerful. I am abundant. I am successful. My body is healing because I'm releasing everything that does not resonate with my higher good. I am an accurate reader. I am an accurate spiritualist. I walk in my power, my divinity. I am a high priestess. I am a voodoo priestess. I am a high priest. I am a voodoo priest. I am a goddess. I am a god. Start speaking your affirmation. Know you the greatest of all times. That's why you called the GOAT. If you don't believe in yourself, no one's going to believe in you. In the summer, do you love me? Do you love me? Do you love me? Do you love me? Do I love you? And no one else but you, Goddess. What is it? Duchess of Goddess. Spirit led me to choose you. What messages do you have for her? Show me clearly. Talk to me clearly. Yea, do I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. For thou are with me. Thy rod and thy staff comfort me. You got to understand, they want you to take that leap of faith, Duchess of Goddess, and understand you are divinely protected. You have an umbrella that God has over you, and that's a huge umbrella. Start calling back your power and your energy. from those low vibrational people that's constantly in your pockets, constantly on there. Just tell them, you know what, damn, I got my own sad story, but thank you for asking about me. Spirit is saying you're going to have a lot of predators. If you see this person, which is you, there's a snake and there's an alligator or a crocodile. Understand that you're divinely protected. Get out of your head and feeling like everything is going to hurt you. They saying Job, touch not thy anointed. You're very anointed. So people are going to pry on you. People are going to prey on you. But you got to understand you're not weak. Start speaking those affirmations on there. Your money is going to come to you because, not your money. Your love is going to come to you because you're very loving. Yes, you got money too, but that's not what I meant. You're very intuitive. Start using your intuitive. You are an empath. You got to understand, a lot of people don't understand that an empath is not weak. An empath is very powerful. Fuck. We can give power, we can take power. We can give energy, and we can take energy. Just know empaths ain't weak. Reason why? Because we cry. Because basically, time we feel sorry for ya, and plus we can feel everything, but that doesn't make us weak. Crying is releasing. Crying is opening the door to strength and humble. That's why when the clouds get black, they purify the earth. We're purifying ourselves when we cry. You know what I'm saying? We don't hold nothing in. We constantly release it. And you are powerful as fuck. You're very intuitive. You need to start telling yourself. You need to start selling your affirmations to you. Because, baby, you can already travel. Spirits is about to take you to a whole new type of level. And I'm talking about as above, so below. Because you're going to start traveling as above on this earth. And you're going to be doing spiritually traveling below. Keep your head up and know that you're divinely protected. People, you always pouring into people. You hardly get poured into back. Spirit is saying you need to be like this, not like this. Because the divine is about to pour abundance into you. And you got to understand abundance is not always money. Abundance can be years added on to your life, health, your children's health. But you got money and prosperity all around you. It's time for you to know who you are. If you want to participate in this pick a card reading, please say that you do and I can write your name down. If this resonates with you, like, share, comment, subscribe. Thank you as always. Peace, bless, namaste. I'll see you.